Hey guys, and welcome to a new episode of Nomadic Dmitry channel. So I was always curious about React.js and what is it all about, and I made a couple of videos about React.js, just trying to install some applications there, trying to use it and trying to see like this Windows alternative, like is it even usable, or like how can you use it in 2020, like for what purposes. And I came to conclusion, well, it's not really usable, only for specific narrow use cases, and that's it. Or like running in a virtual machine. Still, it still has a potential to become a full-fledged operating system, so it's interesting. And I decided, what if I tried this on a Mac machine? So I have a Mac computer, and I wanted to see like if it even boots on that. I was not optimistic from the beginning. I was thinking, well, probably it's not gonna work. And well, let's see. So my first attempt was to run the installer, just to like be able to run the installer, just to plug the CD and see how it boots. And well, immediately after I tried to boot it from a CD, I got the blue screen and it didn't work. So I decided, all right, well, it doesn't work. It just showed the typical blue screen of death with some error displayed. It was something related to memory. And so I expected that it's not gonna work. So okay, my second attempt was to install it on a regular machine, just install it on a regular machine using the same CD and see if it works there. So I plugged it to my other machine, I installed it on this machine, I installed it on the USB flash drive, so I installed on this USB flash drive, and I tried to boot on my Mac. Nothing worked, basically. It showed just a blinking cursor. It shows this cursor when nothing loads. And I tried actually with multiple bootloaders. On Mac, there is like multiple bootloaders you can try. You can first try the standard bootloader. When you hold the option key, you can select which operating system you want to boot. It didn't work. Then I tried the second option, which was refined bootloader. I actually have a video about refined bootloader. And well, it didn't work as well. Same thing. And then I also tried the Clover. Clover is also the bootloader. I also have a video about it. So here is a Clover bootloader. So I actually discussed this is also a bootloader you can use to boot operating system on Mac, actually PC as well. This is like a universal bootloader. And it didn't work either. So I decided what's the next option. So the next option was using the live CD. So if you guys don't know, the React website provides the ISO image of the live CD. And this live CD, I have this right here. So I downloaded this live CD. I burned to the disk, I plugged the disk to the Mac, and again, it was the same thing. It was just showing the blue screen of death, showing the memory error, and nothing really booted. I think the only option left to try was using the bootcamp. So on Mac computers, you have a bootcamp option, which you use to install Windows operating systems on Mac. So you can try bootcamp, and I think it just loads the computer in some BIOS legacy mode. In this BIOS mode, you're able to install the operating system and you're able to run it. So basically some kind of system to emulate BIOS and stuff. But I think those bootloaders also do the same thing. And I basically had the luck using Linux, for example, in the BIOS legacy mode before. Here's my conclusion. The React.os does not work on Mac natively. The only option to boot React.os is probably virtualization. But if you want to, you can try bootcamp option. I mean, if you have time, if you just want to see it, if it works in this scenario. I don't want to try it because it's my main Mac. I don't want to just corrupt all the data because it's React.os is alpha and you can just easily corrupt all the data. So multiple options you can try, multiple bootloaders you can try to like load on Mac, but none of those work, at least on my machine. I'm using the MacBook 2014. It's with i5 processor, and I think it should be able to boot it from it, but well, it doesn't work. Something is lacking here. And again, since the memory I have on the Mac is 16 GB and React.js only supports 4 GB, then well, it's not really practical to even try to use it. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, press the like button. There'll be more videos, and feel free to check out other videos about React.os and installing different operating systems. Thank you.